Let's come back to Delta State. Delta State is known for interesting education. You are a Delta and you've been a lecturer in university. What would you say is informing this propensity for educational quests for Deltans?
It's like an industry in Delta State. If you ask people my age, they will tell you that we went to school not because our parents were rich. They were not rich. Farmers, peasants, but struggled whatever it caused us. My mother would say, since I cannot write my name, my children must be able to write my name. My mother's joy was that I could write her name for her. As far as she was concerned, she had equaled her mates. You see the same thing in Delta State today. It's like, what kind of spirit? Education is what kind of spirit? When you go to a compound, you want to know which university is your child attending. That's the question they ask. Which university, which polytechnic is your child in the College of Education? See, if in the next 15, 20 years, people decide not to attend university again, but to do diploma in Islamic affairs or Christian religious knowledge, we convert them to churches, we convert them to mosques. That would be the need, because a government must listen to the needs of the people, the yearnings of the people. This is what they, right now, these are the yearnings of Deltans. We want education. Give us education. Give us education. We'll give them education. If it's now give us churches or give us mosques, that's what they want. People now start building mosques to train fathers and imams and all of that, and to train pastors. They are no more coming to read study sciences and the arts and law. Fine. So we convert them too to meet the aspirations of the people. But for now and the many decades to come, Delta State will continue to expand educationally, because that is what the people want. Governance is about listening to the people and doing what the people want, not what you want as a governor. The governor of Delta State, Governor Okowa, did not establish this university because that was what he wanted. He established it because that was what the people wanted. The people wanted and still want education space. Okay, my people, you voted me in. Is that what you want me to do? Take it. And they were so excited. They are still very, very excited. They were even more excited this week when they heard that we had passed a lot of the tests by the National Universities Commission, the regulatory body. Okay, you cannot admit into these programs. Not all the programs have we declared to admit into. You cannot admit into these programs. You've done well in this area. You have staff here. You have structures here. But we come again if structures and staff are available and facilities are available in these one or two other programs that you want to engage in. Whatever we are doing, of course, we'll go to NUC. Are we okay with this? Whatever is not okay. And the governor made a promise to the people who visited. This area that you said I should look into, give me 6 months. If you come back, you will not see what you have just seen. We would have corrected the errors, because the idea is for them to come, right? Tell us where we have not done well. Tell us where we have done well. And we have done very, very, very well. Very, very well. Exceedingly well. Right?
Prof, you worked in cabinets. You are in Governor Okowa's cabinet. How would you describe his disposition towards education?
When a man is elected governor, a woman is elected governor, from that moment, he ceases to be a man of himself, a man for himself. He's not a man of the people, for the people. He sits down. He gets requests during the admission period. It will surprise you that people, because his number is known to everybody, his phone number is known to everybody, that people will actually approach the governor for admission. If I had the space as commissioner for education, will a parent who feels that he knows the governor from his village actually approach a governor for admission into university? We should not, but they meet him. He's unable to meet their demands, right? But he internalizes it. Ah, this is serious. This is serious. Commissioner, what is happening to a better admission? Is there fraud in the admission? I'm just saying, no, sir, there is no fraud in the admission. This is our carrying capacity in the university. We cannot take more than this number. Like the year I told you, over 25,000, we are qualified. And we took only 4,000 something. Ah, left to me, I can take all the 25, but we, the regulatory body must tell you, this is what you can take. Right? There's a point beyond which you cannot expand. We're almost busting at the seam. So what do we do, sir? The only option is to establish more. And indeed, so that is what is driving him. What drives a governor is the people. The people drive him. Sir, this is what we want. Sir, this, you go to this local government, they complain. You go to this local government, they complain about the same thing. My son wanted to read medicine, but cannot read medicine. It's somebody's course in the post-UTME is 75% to read medicine. He will not get admission in Delta State University, Abraka. I mean, a child who scores above 70 is a star, but cannot get admission. They're looking for 80 and 90%. Abba. Why? Because there's no space. You know, the JAMB exam is a placement exam. It's not really the true test of knowledge, just to place you. Well, how much space do you have? Okay, for that reason, raise the cutoff point. If you have so many, if you have so much space and very few applied, okay, the cutoff point can come down. So it keeps shifting. Now, for a long time, it has remained at the top. You cannot tell a brilliant child not to read medicine. So how do we solve it? Fine, let's establish more universities that will have colleges of medicine. See, you must demystify some of these courses. You must demystify medicine, demystify law, demystify architecture, theater arts, mass communication, accounting, demystify it. And when I say demystify, I do not mean commonize it. That these are our children can study them too. You understand? It's not only in Yoruba land that they can study law. They can study accounting, medicine, architecture. No, we can study it too, yeah. In Asaba, Agbo, Ozoro, Abraka. We can. So that is it. Demystify it. You know, initially when UI was the only university in Nigeria, to say that your son or daughter was at the University of Ibadan, it's like you should remove a woman should remove her wrapper. I said, my dear, don't step on the ground, walk on it. But with the establishment of more universities, there was a kind of demystification. It's attainable. This thing is not a spirit after all. An undergraduate is not a spirit after all. It's a human being. That's what we are doing in Delta State. These are human beings attending this university. The university is just at your backyard. Nothing can be better than that. You go to Ekpoma. Student population, they're mostly Deltans. That's Ambrose Ali University, mostly Deltans. Go to Afe Babalola. Delta State has the highest number of students. You go to Bell University, You go to Babcock. You go to Warri Airport, where people are going to Babcock, you go to the garage, they charter buses from Delta. Go to Covenant. They are there, and you say government should not be interested in this if they had space. Not all will go to those ones, right? Some are going there for religious purpose. I want my son to attend a religious-based university for the discipline or whatever reason. You cannot stop that. Some are there because they do not have the low-fee-paying universities. And we are saying, okay, let us have the low-fee-paying universities for our children. So like I said, though, if people are angry because we have established three universities, they will continue to be angry because they will be shocked if we establish more.
On a lighter note, Professor, you've worked in public service for a long time now, from being a professor, being ASU chairman. You are now a commissioner. What motivates you?
What keeps me going is somebody from nowhere picks you from the crowd and says, come and drive this, my very important subsector for me. Help me drive it. It's a challenge. It's a very, very big challenge. And I just feel that what will make me happy the most is when the scorecard is given, not by anybody, but by the person who appointed me. And say, Prof, thank you very much, you've done well. I'll just go and sleep as an old man. I'll be there. That's why we do these things, because we believe in them. So the governor does not just tell his commissioner, go and do this. No, he doesn't. He reasons it out with you. So at the end of the day, it's like you are part of, all of us, a commissioner, we are part of his dream. Yeah, we are part of the governor's dream. This is what he wants to do. Okay, we agree this is what we'll do. This is your department, this is your parish or your diocese. Go and handle your diocese. So this is my own diocese too. That's what actually what drives me. You'll be given an assignment, do it to the best of your knowledge. But because I'm not the originator of the policies of government, governor is the originator, sometimes we may not be able to approximate what he wants. Room must be given for that now. I wasn't there when he was thinking them out. He has thought them out. He said, okay, come, jump into the ship, let us do it. So I do not expect that I will do it as well as he would have wanted it done, because I was not there when he was planning it initially. There is little room should be, some degree of freedom should be given for errors. But when we make errors, they are not errors of the heart, that are errors due to sentiments and emotions. No, they will be errors of the head due to lack of knowledge, due to lack of proper understanding of what the situation should be. Such errors are acceptable.
Creation of three universities at the same time is a serious business, considering the infrastructure that requires accreditation and approvals. Where are we on those three new universities created?
Now that we've done verification, after verification, the next stage will be accreditation. Verification means we are okay, you can admit. They will come again. The NEC will never leave you in peace. They will never leave you alone. They will go and come and go and come. The next stage is accreditation. Accreditation is tougher. Accreditation means you can graduate students. We've allowed you what you have. You can bring in your own students. You can teach them. And we are coming back to find out whether you can graduate students, whether they can graduate. The moment a program is verified, the university starts the next journey, accreditation. Otherwise, you will not be allowed to accredit, to graduate students. And of course, in Delta State, once we admit, we must graduate them. We will do whatever is required to graduate. I'm just praying that many years to come, after the governor would have left office, he will meet somebody on the road and who will introduce himself. Hi, Your Excellency, I'm so senior advocate of Nigeria. I graduated from one of your universities that you established when you were governor. Just imagine in your mind how governor Kowa will feel many years from now when he has such introduction. So I say, I'm Dr. So, sir, graduated from University of Delta Agbo College of Medicine. Just now, you know, once you enter the university, you graduate. So those are the rewards the governor expects. The rewards he expects in the future. They are not now. You will not get the rewards now. In the future, when he starts seeing the graduates, theater artists, mass communication experts, accountants. Where did you graduate from? This one, I was in Dentsus at Ebisa. This one, from Agbo. Oh, Dersu. Out of 10, 6 will be from Delta State, one of the universities in Delta State. Those who are jealous will be more jealous.